so close to this girl is half his age. Today's video is brought to you by Arswipe. Please leave some of me for the rest of them. Arswipe, because y'all need it. Okay, good morning. Here we are again. Audio, videos, both working. Everything's flying out. First off, huge shout out to the overwhelming number of ukulele lovers that showed up and expressed their passion for the ukulele. I guess I touched a nerve, but both of these people were very, very kind to me and explained a lot about why they love the ukulele. So that's fantastic for both of you. A couple of rumors to just take care of before we even get going into the other stuff. The video that and the post that I put on Facebook about Jackson Lee, just to clear it up, Jackson is not sick. Well, he has cystic fibrosis, but he does not have COVID. So there was a bit of a rumor going around that I was dealing with last night that just to clarify that Jackson's well at home with his parents taking care of him, and all of everything that we're doing is in order to keep it that way. That's why we're doing all of this stuff. So next point, the High River zone, and being reported that there's two cases of COVID in the High River zone. The High River zone is quite a massive area, and it extends up kind of northeast of Okotoks, up to kind of the Bow River area, and then south all the way down pretty much to Clarisome. So it's a very large area. It does not mean that there are two cases of COVID in High River. My update from the contacts at the hospital is High River directly, we do not have any confirmed known cases of COVID within the town that we know of. So there we are, talking about the hospital. Massive shout out to absolutely everybody that's involved. I gotta turn this thing a little bit. I'm staring at myself, it's getting annoying already. everybody at the hospital that's involved with it, the volunteers, kitchen, maintenance staff, unit clerks, foundation staff, cancer care staff, doctors, nurses, labs, x-ray, chaplain, maternity, health unit downtown, home care nurses, our EMS personnel, everyone that is involved in that facility, you're doing an amazing job. I've been in and out of there a couple of times over the last few days, and this hospital, they have got it ready should it be needed, and they're making sure everybody's screened and everybody goes through the rigmarole to keep everybody safe that's working in there and that's a resident a second floor or in palliative care on third floor or for normal reasons, right? So these people all need to be protected. And so fantastic job that everybody's doing over there. massive shout out to our new first responders that probably never thought they would be first responders one day. But that's the staff working in all our grocery stores right now. These people are in the, we're all in and out of there. And they're trying to be protective as much as they possibly can, but they are going to work every day in order to keep us fed so that we can stay home and still be able to function. So huge shout out to the grocery store staff. The other massive shout out in the same line is to all the truckers that are out there that are keeping the supply chain going. Not just for grocery stores, but everything else that we need. We rely on these individuals in a massive, massive way, and they're largely underappreciated most of the time because they just go out and do their job, and that's about it. But right now, when you see them on the road, give them a wave. They're critical to keeping us going right now. So COVID in the town, again, our responsibility is for our facilities in this town to keep essential services going. All of our essential services continue to run. All of our facilities are now closed, including the town office. You cannot come to the town hall and access any of the services. You have to phone in, and we'll try to help you out as best we can if you absolutely need something from the town. The other piece that was closed this week on Monday morning was all of our park spaces. And, you know, these parks and the playgrounds, the weather's getting busy, and we were just seeing too many people being involved in these playgrounds. And these are surfaces that are messy at the best of times. They are snot factories, and that's just not the environment that you want to have your fingers all over and the kids being all over it right now. So taking precautionary measures and closing those playgrounds. So please, they are off limits, and please, please, please stay away from them. I'll get into some of that other stuff a little later on. Facebook, you know, there's benefits to it. There's also disasters that can come out of it. And right now it can get real, real serious and spiral out of control real fast with the speed of social media. The one thing I want to say, there is no cure for COVID-19 or coronavirus. Same thing. There is no cure. I don't care what you read on there. I don't care who reposted it. There is no cure for COVID right now. You'll know about it when it shows up. There's no vaccine for it. There's no cure for it. There might be some antivirals that might help if you've got that. We have to take this extremely serious, and do not think and sit on your hands thinking that you're 6 days away from a cure. It's false. The other piece with this hydrochlorinazone stuff, whatever it's called, there are actually people with health conditions that need that drug because of what's been spewed out there. They're now having trouble getting it for their condition. It's ridiculous. It's irresponsible and everything else for anybody to be posting this stuff that there's a cure for this right now. So, and continue to go back. The last thing that we can have happen, yes, we're a week further into this thing, but do not become complacent with where we're at. Things are starting to feel, our new normal is starting to show up, and we're kind of adjusting to things and being at home a lot more and dealing with this stuff. But I'll go back to it. Consistently assume or pretend you have this virus and conduct yourself as though you have it. If you have to go out to the grocery store, I started wearing gloves in the grocery store. Everything that's in that store has been touched by other people. Be careful, be very, very careful. The story about little Jackson Lee and his parents, Brady and Wes, you know, a family of rock stars helping us get this awareness out, and they showed up in a big way, and we're doing all of this to protect absolutely everybody. And the little guys like Jackson, this does not just affect senior citizens. Middle-aged group of people, they are the ones that are hospitalized most through this. And then you get down into little guys like Jackson. They need us, and we've got to be there for them, and we have to be taking this seriously and taking all the necessary precautions. So I continue to hear it. Oh, you'll see somebody, they got a stuffy nose or something, and oh, it's just a cold. Run. If you got somebody that's still taking that attitude, do not, if you have just a cold, do not assume it is just a cold. Assume and take precautions as though it is, because if you have it, number one, if you just have a cold, you're not getting a test. So you don't know. So you have to be able to take all the precautions necessary, hand washing, sanitizing, social distancing, physical distancing, whatever you want to call it, stay away from others, please. You have the ability to transmit this disease via surfaces, via your speech, your breath. It doesn't last long airborne, but if you're too close to somebody, it's transmittable. All of this is being done, and I'm still getting the guys that think, and it's a guy thing, it's a tough guy thing, right? We got this. We're doing all of this so that we can get through this as fast as possible. I don't care whether you're a retail owner downtown, whether you're an oil and gas worker. This is going to start affecting the agriculture world as well. It's affecting every single business. And those of us that are running these businesses and working in these businesses, we want to get back to normal work. This is costing us a lot, and we want to get back to work. You got to take this seriously for us to keep this thing going as well as it is right now, if you call it that. The faster and the better job we do right now gets us through this faster so that we can get back to work and get back to making things happen. And like I said, I don't care, oil and gas sector, in the guy's guy world, ag, everything else. Just take this so seriously right now so that we can all get through this. Again, social distancing, wave, say hi, don't go near each other. Stockpiling, stop it, please. We're, the supply chain is there. When you see toilet paper, you don't need 9 bundles of it. We're down to our last 2 rolls at home, I think, and it's not looking good for getting more right now. So as far as the residents piece, I'm gonna do a little blurb here because we've noticed it at home with, Oren gets it, he's 5-year-old. He kind of gets it. We're watching some videos and stuff as on YouTube to try to, educate him as best as we can. And I'm very lucky because, as a lot of you know, my wife, Lindsay, is a registered nurse. She's a midwife, and she is a card-carrying germaphobe. And if you want something that is an extreme asset in your household right now, it is having a germaphobe available. Now, most of the time, this is a real pain in my asset, most of the time. During this time with COVID, coronavirus, I love it, and I'm all in. She has got me tweaked, I'll tell you what. I'm gonna do a little demo here, because this can maybe, I think getting the kids involved in this can help them kind of understand it more. And I'm gonna call this COVID Hunter or Virus Hunter, whatever name you wanna put on it. But all you need is a cloth, one of these, a bucket of hot water, and a little bit of bleach. You got your cloth, you got your water. Now, all you need is just a little dab of bleach. That's probably 10 times too much as to what you really need. But, or you can take the Lindsay Snodgrass route and just make darn sure that you're gonna get this dealt with. And you got your rag. And you're gonna get your rag all nice and wet, right? With almost straight bleach now. Now, when you're at the grocery store, when you're at home, you got this rag and you just go around wiping surfaces. Trent and Crystal Williamson over at Diamond Embroidery put a hashtag, Focus on High River. And I think this is a really important piece because it gets overwhelming looking at what's going on Earth and trying to decipher and trying to sort this out through your head. Focus number one on yourself, number two on your family, number three on your house and your community. That's how the list goes. And you've got this, These things coming out of the grocery store, your apples, even a box of Kraft dinner, when it comes home, wipe it all down. You don't know what, I just got a cold person, just grab this thing or this thing. It's gross. Get these cloths out. Lindsay is on this stuff. The bottoms of my shoes, I'm not allowed to have them in the house anymore, but they get bleached too. So she bleached my truck. Kind of freaked me out. Had a little bit of an issue there for a few minutes, but I was a little worried the interior of my truck was going to turn into a pair of Kelly Mallenberg's tie-dye Jordache jeans, but it didn't happen. It's safe. Just use a little bit. Not as much as a joke. Okay. It's just a joke. A little bit of bleach on a cloth and go to cleaning. Get your house clean. What gets brought in when people come in, it could be there. The more you're cleaning, just keep that thing on the ready. It's constant. And I think it's a massive, massive thing, but focus on, don't get wrapped up. Try not to when you're looking at everything that's going on Earth. Narrow it down to what you've got control of and what you can really do your part with. And a little rag of bleach and away you go. Just go to virus hunting. Go to COVID hunting, kids. Give all the kids one. Get at it. Business-wise, there's a lot of businesses that are just voluntarily closing up for the time being downtown just because there's not enough customers coming in, number one. Number two, it's just the responsible thing to do regardless of what's the actual rules out of the province, which we're expecting that we're going to end up down the same lines as Ontario, but that hasn't happened yet. But I'm going to go through a few of what some of the businesses are doing. But a note for the businesses. This is not the first time we've been through this gig. And this money that keeps getting talked about with the federal government, $100 billion now, whatever it is. If you remember back in the flood days with the DRP program, it was a nightmare. And that was a very, very small area that was being dealt with in this province. Now it's the whole country. So if you remember what the rigmarole was going through that DRP nightmare to try to get your funds back, this is going to be DRP times a million. So be very, very careful with your finances right now. It's my guess, but we've been through it. I'm using my own knowledge that accessing these billions of dollars for your own little business is going to be quite the task. So just be very, very careful with your money right now. Watch the loans and everything else. There's lots of stuff that's coming out from some of the accounting firms and everything. And, you know, just stick with each other and keep networking with each other. I got my High River Fight Club group, and they're quite the group of individuals anyway. So, but we've all got each other's backs through this, and that's what you kind of need is a group around you, whether it's at home or with your business. Just keep talking with each other. It's a big deal. So what some of the businesses are doing, you know, the voluntary closures, how we do hair and nails over here on Fifth, voluntarily closed. It's the right thing. They just felt it was the right thing to do. So kudos to them. Some of the online things that are happening, In Spirit Yoga, Karen's doing some online yoga classes that you can log into and get signed up and do some yoga at home, stay in shape. It's a big, big deal to stay healthy right now. The Hub PT, Lisa is still doing her online stuff. There was more on it this morning. So lots of fitness stuff that's going on. Westridge Laser and Massage down the street here, they're also offering free online yoga classes. Dr. Sarah Main is offering home delivery of essential oils. Beautiful Blooms Flower Shop, if you need some flowers at home. Shelly's doing some free delivery. No Frills is limiting the number of people in store and encouraging only one family member at a time to shop. And I think that's really critical. one family member in these grocery stores at a time so that others can get in there. I understand there's lineups in Calgary and stuff. So just be cognizant of what's going on there. Refresh and Okotoks Natural Foods, they're offering free home delivery and special times for seniors and immune compromised people to shop. Colossi's Coffee Shop, they're still delivering. I think all the coffee shops in town that I know of, they're all still delivering. Sobeys in High River has started an online ordering platform that you can, if you can't get out, there's lots of volunteers that are available on Facebook, or you just ask around to your friends. There's lots of people that are trying to help out and go get groceries for seniors and deliver them. Seniors, it's a big deal for you to stay home and stay out of this. So let us younger folks try to get this stuff for you. And there's lots of people that are doing it. So all you got to do is ask quickly. But Sobeys is doing some online ordering, and you can just email your order over to Jason and the staff over there, and they'll get it all packed up and deliver it to you. They have a special email address for the High River store, which is SobeysHRGroceryOrder@gmail.com. So SobeysHRGroceryOrder@gmail.com. So lots going on, and I know I'm not going to get all that. I got absolutely bombarded with requests of what to mention, and council's trying to keep bringing me stuff that I can mention on this video as well. So ending off with the town of High River, as to kind of what we're working on as a council and what we're trying to do to ease some of this financial burden on everybody, but we are seriously trying to get, and we'll probably get with the help of the provincial government, but getting our tax increase down to 0%. This isn't something that any of us normally do, because I view 0% increases as more irresponsible than anything on normal tasks, because we have to keep the services going. But this is much different. This is not normal, as everybody knows. So with the education tax being that increase being waived by the province this week, that allows us to get down to 0% tax increase. So that does not mean your taxes are going to be zero. It just means there won't be any increase this year. So utility penalties and interest. So few things on your property taxes. Your property tax accounts will not have any penalties or interest applied for the next 3 months until June 30th, 2020. May get extended as we see how this thing goes, but right now it's up to June 30th. No interest or penalties for late payment on there. So you've got a little bit of a grace period. The money is still due. You still have to pay your property taxes. Utilities the same way. No penalties, no interest for the next 3 months. Your utility bill is still due at that time. So don't just do this for slush fund cash, because you're going to get a big bill at the end of it. Anyways, if you absolutely have to use it, it's available to you. If you don't, continue on as normal. And then any accounts receivable that we have through the town will not have penalties or interest as well. Same thing, does not waive the payment, only defer. So few things with the town. Man, I've got a lot of stuff here. Chris, Prosser, all of our staff, police, fire, everybody that's involved, our operations staff, they're flying, trying to keep everything going. Our water treatment plant, garbage, recycling. The recycling depot, I'll be honest, it's a little bit up in the air as to whether we're going to close that or not. So if you're at that recycling center, just be, if it's still open, things are changing very, very fast. By the time this video is done, it might have changed. But be aware of your social distancing and wear gloves. Don't touch surfaces over there. But again, our CAO, Chris, he's just working his butt off, as are all of our staff, whether they're working at home or split shifts in the office to keep distance going. Rec center staff, everybody is doing everything they can to keep this thing, keep the essential services that we need to provide happening, and everything's fine. Interesting thing, our building permits are actually up, and a lot of that comes from all the husbands that are home. You got your list now, right? So there's a few rentals going on at home that people are taking advantage of the time. So our building permits are actually up, and home builds are up right now actually too. So town staff is working on, it started to work on recovery planning so that we're ready when things start to come back online, that we can transition our staff back into a normal environment as quick as possible. So digital signs around town, those went out yesterday, I think. So just constant messaging to everybody and as to how important this is, and to continue to be very, very serious about your social distancing. You can be outside. It's good to get some fresh air, but stick in your family groups. Do not go and get five of your neighbors. Do not have block parties with all the kids running around in and out of each other's houses. Just please, it's not safe to do that right now. But get out for some walks, spend your family time, enjoy the fresh air, enjoy the weather. If you're on happy trails, please do not stop in your groups and chat with others. Just say hi and keep walking, keep moving on these, in these areas. And we've got to keep this going. This is still very, very serious. We cannot start to get complacent now. We're going to continue being, hammering this message home. We're not done yet, and we got a ways to go. So we will provide new information as it becomes available. highriver.ca, it's your local resource for anything new that's coming on. Michelle and Donna are doing a fantastic job of keeping not just the whole community, but keeping all of us abreast as to exactly what's going on right now. So that's about all I got. Are there any questions? Okay, so I'll rewind. I started out with the number of cases. So there is a rumor. It's not a rumor. They're in the High River zone, and that's what's been reported, is that in the High River zone, there are two cases. Now, the High River zone extends a very, very large area. It's small on the map, but physically it's a very large area that extends from northeast of Okotoks, does not include Okotoks, but comes all the way down past Okotoks, takes in High River east and west to a certain distance, and then all the way includes Nanton, and then south of Nanton, pretty much all the way to Claire's home. You can go on alberta.ca or Alberta Health Services. These maps are available for you, and you can go in and you can zoom right in to have a look as to what's going on. So, in the High River zone, there are two cases. In High River, according to contacts at the High River Hospital that I got just yesterday, we do not have any known cases in the actual town of COVID. And this is why we're doing it. We're gonna keep it that way. So that's why this stuff at home is extremely important, extremely important. And thanks to my wife for teaching me the lessons on the bleach rag and finally getting me to buy into it. So do it at home. Keep your community safe. Focus on High River. And we'll get through this. Got a little ways to go, but we're here for you. Another question. That's it. We're good. Rock and roll. Take care. Bye-bye.